And I'd like to speak in English because I know that you're going to do the whole program in English, so let's get started with it, right? I wanted to say a few words, but before I do, I want to introduce Karima Daoud Alpouch. She's here from Washington, D.C. She's our liaison with the U.S. Embassy to our Washington, D.C. office, and we're happy to have her here to see this flagship program that we're so proud of. Since I started my job in April, I've been working with Tiziana Candelora at the Embassy in the cultural section. Our sponsors at the Fondazione, who organize this program, and all of the people who make this work. And finally, I get to see a part of the program and see it in action. So again, I'm really happy to be here. I just want to thank all the teachers and the schools who are embracing this exciting project and recognizing the importance of training the next generation in this field and tackling the stereotypes that women are less passionate in science and technology, engineering, mathematics, or as we call it, STEM. I'm really happy to meet Emily Tomford too, finally, to see this program and see someone from the U.S. who is here to train you all. Sorry, I hope you could all hear me. And I want to congratulate all of you who are participating because this is a really good initiative that you're taking part in. I hope you don't mind if I just tell you a little story that I hope inspires you a bit to do what you're already doing. So I was really proud of myself last century, I want to say, when I graduated from the university, and 4 years at the university, I never touched a computer. And I graduated and I said, made it, did it, never touched a computer, happy. And then I went to try out for my first job in the newspaper industry, and the newsroom was full of computers, or word processors, but they were these old blue boxes back then. And I was told to sit down at this blue box and write a story from some notes that they gave me. And what they gave me at that time, this is a lot of years ago, were a list of codes. You didn't just turn it on, type in a password and start. You had a list of codes that you had to type in order to get to the page where you could write it. And I sat there for about a minute, frozen, because what did I know? I didn't even know where the on button was.